Hello, I'm Atuba George. Now, usually I don't do broadcasts on Saturdays, but this early hours of this morning, the word of the Lord came to me, and it's important I share this message and I'm about to share with you. And this thing, the Lord is saying that this week we are stepping into, between now and the 28th, which is next week Saturday, is a very crucial week. Crucial, not because of coronavirus. No, actually the Lord said coronavirus is a distraction. Take your eyes off it to what I am about to do. Now, the Lord says he wants to spend time this week to prepare the church, which is his body, for what he is about to do. And then let me tell you what the Lord said to me. The Lord said, look, even this coronavirus have come to prove that the church is not as strong as it should be. See, we are his body. We represent him on earth. But we are not taking the place that we ought to take. We are the light of the world. We are not supposed to be shutting down when the world is shutting down. The world is supposed to be running to us for answers even now. But that's by the way. What the Lord is about to do in us is to prepare us for the coming days. Listen, if you don't get yourself in that place, now I'm not talking about a church calling for a prayer meeting, you know, I'm not talking of someone saying National Day of Prayer, that's not what I'm talking about. I'm talking about you who believe in Jesus Christ. It is time to go to him, that he will prepare you by himself. Now, the prayer focus of this preparation is what Paul said in Galatians chapter 4 and verse 19. He says, I travail from birth until now, until Christ be formed in you. You see, there are lots of believers who have not had Christ formed in them. They go to church, they do all the church things, but Christ is not formed in them. You see, and that's a big problem, because Jesus is not just coming for good Christians. I'm talking about the outward good Christians now. He is coming for those who mirror him. So now, he wants to spend time to prepare you for himself because of what is coming ahead. And someone says, well, okay, tell us what is coming ahead. That is not as important as you being prepared for it. You know, I remember the rich man that came to Jesus. And the man said, what will I do that will inherit life? And Jesus said, look, do all this. He said, I've done that from my youth. And Jesus said, one thing you lack. And the man said, what is it? Jesus never told him that thing that he lacked. But Jesus said, go sell everything you have, give to the poor, and come and follow me. So what did the man lack? Jesus didn't say. So what is about to happen is not as important as how you are prepared for it. Now, here's what the Lord is saying. You, as a child of God, if you will spend in the next 1 week, if you will spend at least 1 hour a day with the Lord, doing what? Praying in the Holy Ghost. I'm not just talking about sitting down and singing worship songs. I'm not talking about singing worship songs right now. I'm not talking about teaching right now. I'm talking about real prayer. And your prayer point is simple. Like I said, according to Galatians chapter 4 verse 6, until Christ be formed in me. Now, when you set yourself, listen, declare it first of all, proclaim it first of all before the Lord. Say, Lord, I'm spending these days at least 1 hour. I said at least 1 hour praying in the Spirit. You are not the one that is going to be doing the praying. Jesus is going to be manifesting his truth from within you through the Holy Ghost. See, someone says, so what do you mean? What if I cannot pray in tongues? Hey, if you do not pray in tongues, look for someone you know is a genuine believer who prays in tongues and tell him, look, I want to start praying in tongues. This is very important. You know, someone, if I don't pray in tongues, does it mean that I will not make heaven? Listen, you may be at the risk of not making heaven. I'll tell you why. Jesus gave a parable in Matthew chapter 22. He said, a rich man called for a feast, and the people he invited didn't show up. So he told his servants, go into all the streets, get everybody that you can get. So it was an all open party for anybody. And then they all came. But during the feast, the man began to go around and he found a man who was not wearing his wedding garments. Now, what did he do to him? You can read that yourself in Matthew 22 from verse, I think, 11 and 12. And the man said to this guy, look, why not wearing your wedding garment? He was speechless. And he said, look, cast this man into outer darkness. Think about it. Speaking in tongues might just be your wedding garment. So why do I say that? Jesus said in Mark chapter 16, this sign shall follow them that believe. And one of the striking things he said, they said they will speak with new tongues. They will speak with new tongues. Now, among all the things that Jesus listed, speaking in tongues is the only one that you don't need any external force before you do. See? Because it says, in my name they shall cast out demons. You need to find a demon before you cast it out. See? It says, they will speak with new tongues. They shall take up serpents. You say, serpent need to show up for you to take it up. If they drink any deadly thing, it shall not hurt them. Now, isn't that even amazing? These are the things Jesus said are the signs of the believers. He says, if they drink any deadly thing, it shall not hurt them. Now, when we drink deadly things, it doesn't hurt us. How much more that when we touch? And today we are scared of touching. He said, we shall lay hands on the sick and the sick shall recover. That is who we are when we believe in Jesus Christ. Praise God. So the Lord is saying, this season, He wants to prepare you. This is why you need to be praying in the Holy Ghost. So if you don't pray in tongues, find a true believer around you. This is not a time to be ashamed. This is not, look, go hold the person and say, you know what? I want to speak in tongues right now. And I have no one thing that the Spirit of God will help that person minister to you to speak in tongues. Or you can just go before the Lord and say, Lord, I think right now I'm ready to receive the Holy Ghost. I'm ready to speak in tongues. Because you need it now. The kind of prayer I'm talking about is not a prayer you can pray in your senses. The kind of prayer I'm talking about is the prayer that the Holy Ghost Himself had to pray through you. And He can only do that when you can pray freely in the Holy Ghost. So I sense that this week there's going to be so much outpouring of the Holy Spirit in our lives. Praise God. So this is the time to be who you have never imagined to be before in God. This is the season. So let me tell you this. Spend at least 1 hour. Listen, if you cannot do it alone and you have believers around you, one or two believers around you, you believe you have that time, create that time to go spend time and pray with, do that. Christ is coming to form Himself in us. And let me tell you this, we are going to be rising up in boldness like never before. We are rising up with so much courage that the world has never seen. Because the coming days shall be the manifestation of those who know their God. They are going to be doing exploits. Something is about to happen even in our nation, Nigeria, that God needs to prepare you for. Now, all over the world, wherever you are, don't be afraid of coronavirus. Keep your eyes on Jesus Christ and do what He will tell you to do. And listen, there is no virus anywhere that can touch you. Praise God. Thank you very much. Listen, take this message seriously. 1 hour praying in the Holy Ghost. Now, I'm not saying that after 1 hour you stop. I'm saying the minimum is 1 hour. Now, if the Lord inspires me during the week, I will still share some things with you. Otherwise, we have already had a broadcast we're going to be sharing next week. God bless you. Bye-bye.